going nowhere. Feels like I'm falling, trying to land on air. And I'm breathing, but my heart's not beating the way it was before. These ghosts were knocking on my door, and my dreams are part of me. How far they may be, you can take the ground from beneath my feet. You can knock the breath right out of me. And my body might not be that strong, but my mind. I came to win. And there are days when I'm sure I can't take anymore, and I remember what I'm fighting for, and I know I won't be alone. I can't win this battle on my own. You can take the ground from beneath my feet. You can knock the breath right out of me. And my body might not be that strong, but my mind. I'm still holding on. Thought you could beat me, but you were wrong. I will win. Yeah, I came to win.
T6 and T7, so I got some process of learning how to walk. graduated high school and thought I was invincible and found out I wasn't real fast. But throughout this process, I've met people I would have never met, like Elle. Just amazing people. And you don't realize how many people are in wheelchairs who have had accidents until it happens to you or someone around you. And then it's the simplest things are so hard. Like, I remember the first time I tried to get a dish out of the cupboard, I couldn't get it just because I couldn't stand up and I couldn't, and it was just 6 inches away. You take little things for granted, for sure, but just like Gary said, everything that he's talked about, it goes hand in hand with what I've had to deal with. I mean, you have to have the faith to know that you're going to do it. There was never a doubt in my mind that I wouldn't walk. It was just a matter of how long and how much time I was willing to put into it, unfortunately. And I've been blessed with a great surrounding of family and friends. They support me 100% in whatever I did, whether it was getting back on the motorcycle a couple months out of the hospital. My mom was gone, my dad and my friend threw me on, and I rode down the street. She was in the store, so we figured it was safe. And my little brothers, who were at the time, one was 10 and one was 12, were riding alongside me on mountain bikes, so in case I did start to fall over, they were supposed to catch me. We didn't have to find that out, though, so. But, I mean, I still live life. I still have fun. I've got a motorcycle set up that I ride, and I ride motorcycles, I ride four-wheelers, I do everything the same, pretty much. I've just learned how to adapt and do things differently, which is all you can do when life hands you a crappy car. You just pick it up and run with it. Or in my case, you just kind of stumble and fall and figure out how to do it. But no, you just can't give up. That's the biggest thing. You have two choices when you wake up in the morning. You can either have a bad attitude and just go about the day, oh, life is so terrible, why does this have to happen to me? Or you can just be positive and just be happy and enjoy life, even if it is a little different than you planned. You just have to figure out how to do the things that you wanted to do before. You just have to do them differently. And, just enjoy life. Enjoy the little things. Thanks for having me.
I think I know we started a little bit late, but I want to